Hello friends, myself Dr. S.K. Tiwari. I am assistant professor in D.P. Vipra College, Bilaspur. Bilaspur is the second important city of Chhattisgarh. So I will give my lecture on a general estimate of Chaucer as a poet. So Chaucer is the earliest of the great moderns. As you all know, he has been called the father of English poetry. Albert calls him the earliest of the great moderns. What is important about Chaucer? That he stands at the end of the Middle Ages and the beginning of the modern age. He has been called the morning star of the Renaissance. His poetry reflects the medieval spirit as well as that of the Italian Renaissance. There can be no greater tribute to his genius than the fact that for the next 150 years, there was none to match him. He stands head and shoulders above his contemporaries. And not only contemporaries, I would rather say he stands above his successors as well. Now, something about Chaucer's modernism. His modernism consists in his realism, Renaissance note in his poetry, modern nature of his humor, and in the fact that Chaucer is the maker of modern English. We can also see modern note in his versification. And when you will analyze all, you will see the modern world of Chaucer. So, what it comprises of? Chaucer's realism, his characterization, his humor, his rejection of medieval conventions, his Catholicity of outlook, his zest for life, his humanism, and last but not the least, his services to the English language and versification. All together entitle him to be called the earliest of the great moderns. Now something about Chaucer's descriptions. His descriptions are vivacious and brilliant. His descriptions are sunny and colorful. His use of similes is apt and delightful. We don't find in him any Homeric similes or rather say epic similes which interrupt the flow of descriptions. Long similes, epic similes, what they do? They distract the attention of the readers. So there is no epic similes. In Chaucer's descriptions, you will find calm and gentle description of nature. Some critics they say that is nature descriptions are one-sided. He loves only the calm, the gentle, and the peaceful side of nature. He does not describe the wilder aspect of nature, as the mountains, as the oceans, and the storms. Now come to Chaucer's narrative art. Critics enumerate his faults by blaming him, the prince of plagiarists. Why? Because he borrowed from the classical sources. Critics also say that Chaucer has fondness for long speeches. But in my view, even his faults are virtuous. Why? His digressions and long speeches, they add variety and philosophical depth to his tales. They remove the feeling of rigidity without creating any confusion or weakness in narration. Regarding his merits, his mastery of the art of narration has led many to call Chaucer the father of the English novel. Chaucer is often called the father of English poetry. It would be perhaps less flattering, but certainly true, to call him the father of the English novel. Take, for instance, his Troilus and Cressida. It is the first English novel in everything except that it is written in verse. It is a long love story, and it has all the elements of a modern novel. His Canterbury Tales are so many novels in miniature. They are only to be translated in prose to become so many modern novels. S.D. Neale rightly remarks, had Chaucer written in prose, it is possible that his Troilus and Cressida and not Richardson's Pamela would be celebrated as the first English novel. For narration, Chaucer uses dramatic method. His method of narration is dramatic. Why? Because all his characters, they speak in a dramatic manner, and the spirit of comedy pervades through all the tales. And that is why some have even called him the father of the English drama. It is only an accident of time that his tales do not appear in dramatic form. Otherwise, he had all the gifts of a great dramatist. Had he written in the age in which Shakespeare wrote, he would have been ranked as the first great dramatist of England. His characterization, dialogues, plots, conflict, humor, all are dramatic in nature. But despite all that, Chaucer has some limitations as well. He represents the growth of intelligence and the consequent weakening of passion and imaginations. Since a lyric is a compound of imagination and passion, there is lack of lyricism in his poetry. Some critics found Chaucer wanting in that sublimity and high seriousness, particularly Matthew Arnold. He says that Chaucer is lacking in sublimity and high seriousness. Arnold considers this is the test of all great poetry, that all great poetry must be sublime and there must be a high level of seriousness. So therefore, Matthew Arnold did not regard him as a great poet, as the great classics. So how we may conclude? Despite his limitations, he is the undisputed father of English poetry. He may not be a poet of very first order, but we find in his poetry a lot of zest for life and a refreshing enjoyment in his work. We get from him sanity and balance. So whatever the limitations the critics threw on him, he is certainly among the few greatest poets of the world. His greatness is shown by the barrenness of literature for the next 200 years. His narration has also dramatic elements, and he may also be called the father of English drama. So he may be called the father of the English poetry. He may be called the father of the modern English novels. He may be called the father of the English drama. And for the next 200 years, there was no poet of his stature came. It shows how far great he was. Certainly, he stands among the few greatest poets of the world. Thank you.
अरे इधर बंद करो ना, हो गया।